Measuring and Advancing Soldier Tactical Readiness and Effectiveness is a 5-year Army science and technology program. MASTR-E seeks to measure, predict, and enhance soldier and squad close combat performance through quantified measures of performance, baselining and assessments, as well as small unit performance forecasting. The fifth and final year is focused on demonstrating program capabilities and human performance outcomes with soldiers and small units.
MASTR-E seeks to collect data on soldier performance in order to give leaders in the Army data points they can use to organize training and better application of their soldiers during operations. We have watches and a ring that tracks our sleep, that tracks activity, that tracks how much we're eating, and then ties that to performance metrics, which gets you in that headspace.
And the ramp-up tool was actually a predictive analysis tool that allowed us to see a group, a rifle platoon size, and based off of the environmental and all of the different factors that the ramp-up tool measures, where will they be most effective and what task will be most effective?
What I've observed is a lot of conversations about, you know, their data.
It was kind of fun just talking about it to each other, seeing who's like getting the most rest, maybe grilling the guy who isn't getting enough.
Soldiers are automatically paying attention to their sleep a little more closely, paying attention to their food intake a little more closely, and regulating it better.
What I expect to see out of the ramp-up tool is the bridge between training and combat.
MASTR-E is real simply quantifying things and capturing data about soldiers to conduct predictive analysis and understand our soldiers better and create a more ready Army.
So having that baseline that you had before you went out to the field and then coming back and getting those new metrics that you had, you can see where you declined and where you need to be again.
We're not doing anything transformative in our training. What we're actually doing is understanding what our doctrine already says.
The value that really comes with the MASTR-E program is it creates a scoring criteria and a list of standards that allows you to grade soldiers very objectively and create a competitive attitude among soldiers, which drives them to improve themselves and each other.
So before MASTR-E, some of the more senior specialists weren't very confident and their abilities. During MASTR-E, I pushed some of these guys to take spot reports, to be the first ones to go, like during the stress shoot. And now after MASTR-E, they've shown me that they can be confident.
I was really surprised by how I was starting to miss shots at the end, because I wasn't aware that I was doing that. But when I got off the range and I was seeing where my shot groupings were, they were opening up. I wasn't aware of that, and if I had been at the time, it probably would have impacted my breathing control, the way I would have been aiming, the way I would have been moving. Now that I have that information, it means the next time I'm shooting under pressure, the next time I'm feeling this level of fatigue, I'm going to incorporate that knowledge, what I've learned, into that next event. So I know that's what I took out of it, and I'm pretty sure that's what my guys will take out of it as well.
My readiness score was like a 47, and I could really feel like my cognitive function really like took longer to process things. It took me a little bit longer to identify things around my environment. Maybe I wasn't as alert, but let's say for example, at the beginning of this week, I got enough sleep. My readiness score was at a 90. I felt ready to go. Physically, I was performing at pretty much my peak.
There's little ways that fatigue or a lack of sleep or a lack of food impacts our performance that you might not be aware of unless you're actually putting it to hard numbers.
I'm fascinated by how we're taking heart rate variability, understanding the impacts on not only the physical domain, which I think is very apparent, but also on decision making, communication, marksmanship, land navigation. Now by quantifying some of this stuff, we can kind of anticipate and we can do this predictive analysis of, how we think they're going to be able to communicate or put a piece of equipment in operation.
As we as leaders continue to do this research and continue to do studies with MASTR-E, it builds a trust in the data. The more that we can see that those data points coincide with actual performance outcomes, those data points will be viewed as predictive and will begin to factor in probably very heavily into how planning plays out.
You could have a website that you log into and see all the things right there, real time, and that would provide commanders with all the information they needed.
It's not at the expense of the commander's instinct. It's, now I have data to back up things I think or to inform my decision making to prevent me from making an emotional decision.
The MASTR-E program, from my perspective, is giving back to the United States Army.